Hey guys, James Schultz here, Second Mile Servants Lawn Care and Landscaping. Wanted to do an update video and tell you what's been going on with me. Hope everybody's season was well. Hope you guys made plenty of money, picked up new contracts, got new equipment. Whatever your goals were, whatever your plans were for the season, man, I hope you accomplished that. I just want to give you guys a kind of update of what's been going on with me. I apologize about the lack of videos. I've just been super busy, and I've been doing everything by myself as far as my grass cutting and everything, so it's been kind of tough to keep up. This season has gone exceptionally well. I'm right at about 40, 45 properties, and just climbing, man, just trying to get it to a point where I can do this full time. I love what I do, and very passionate about my craft. Again, I hope everybody's doing well. Right now, I just kind of want to give you guys an overview of the shop, the garage, and then I got some footage of a landscape job later on in the video I'll let you check out. So first off, we'll show you the shop. We'll get a kind of wide view of everything, just kind of an overview. Over here on the left are my blowers, my Husqvarna 350, and then down below it is my brand new to me Husqvarna 570 BTS. Bad blower, man. Biggest one on the market. The equivalent of the Red Max 75, 8500. Those blowers, you guys are familiar with those. Incredible blower. As far as this wall goes, all my handheld equipment. Up top is my pole saw, my Husqvarna pole saw. And then we have the two trimmers, the 223Ls, and then my 128LD edger. And then we have the 323 LS articulate hedge trimmer. And then the HD 145, 122 HD 45, I'm sorry, Husqvarna handheld hedge trimmer. This back wall, all my miscellaneous hand tools. I'm huge on organization and just kind of keeping everything flowing and looking good and that kind of stuff. So it was a big deal to me to build that shelf, just to kind of have everything staggered out, you know, shovels, rakes, bow rakes, and then the flat shovels and the grain scoops right there, just to kind of have everything in order and just kind of looking good. As far as the main equipment I run, we have the Toro push mower. It's a 22-inch with the Kohler on it. Incredible push mower. Love it, man. And then my walk behind, 36-inch Cub Cadet. Belt drive with the Velke, and then has the Kawasaki motor on it. And then the big mower is my zero turn. This is a Cub Cadet 48-inch RZT S-Force with the fab deck on it. Has a 24-horse Kawasaki, dual fuel tanks. Stripes great, man. It's been a heck of a mower. Would I have gone with a bigger size mower? Yes and no. The 48 is perfect for my needs right now. 36 for small yards and gates. 48 for the medium sized yards to the big properties. So I have everything I need as far as my mowers go. The next piece of equipment is my new new shredder vac I actually picked up a couple weeks ago just for leaf cleanups. This is a Cub Cadet walk behind leaf vac. Has the bagger, collection bagger on the back, and then has this tube that comes across where you're able to suck up leaves from flower beds and clean up and that kind of stuff. Very good unit for small residential leaf cleanup stuff I do is perfect. Eventually I'll get into like a leaf loader and a dump trailer and all that kind of stuff, but that'll be later on down the road. You guys remember in previous videos I talked about picking up one of these. Well, it was the season and I was able to get one and very fortunate to come across one and get a good deal on it. Next we have, you guys, again, you follow me on Instagram, Facebook. I actually built this new shelf today, to hold all my, hand tools. And, here we have, you know, just my assortment, this shelving unit, and then drills, impact, you know, angle grinders, sawzall, and then all my skill saws, jigsaws, that kind of stuff, sanders, drill bits, you know, wire spool, and then we have a parts organizer. Just to kind of keep everything organized and flowing together. And then my chop saw station. And then we have my big air compressor. Moving along, this is my toolboxes. I try to keep everything organized. as you can see, it has it written on there. I won't necessarily pull them all open, but you guys kind of get the idea. Screwdrivers, wrenches, and try to keep everything kind of lined up in good shape, just so you can kind of find it with these. Then you got rags and gloves and that kind of stuff. And then these are like go-to sockets. These are ones that I'm going to use all the time. So these are ones that I'll pull first. This bottom drawer is paint accessories, rollers, drop cloths, that kind of stuff. Here we have my workbench. Just all the main tools that I would use. I mainly use Ryobi power tools, so I'm a big fan of those, man. Shout out to Ryobi. They make great products. These are all my batteries. This is a 6-port charging station, so it's able to charge them all at one time and maintain them. Here we have, your wrenches, screwdrivers, tape measures, Allen keys, channel locks, hammers, etc. Next we have my bench grinder. This is where I sharpen my blades. I do any kind of maintenance on the blades and that kind of stuff. Here are my shop vacs. I keep those down low, just kind of out of the way when I need them. Next we have kind of my liquid fuel station over here. These are just kind of sprays. I'll get out of the way so you guys can see. Sprays, then kind of paints and bar and chain oil, acetate, and then all my two-stroke oil right there in that box. I just buy a box of it at a time when I need it. Then my pressure washers. I have this 2600 Honda red top pressure washer, and then I just bought this one, this Ryobi 2600 pressure washer as well. I caught a good deal on it, and it's been a great pressure washer. Then I have my fridge, towels to kind of clean up, buckets up top, keep those out of the way. Next we have my wheel barrels and my spreader. Keep those up high, kind of out of the way, just so you guys can kind of see those. I have 3 wheel barrels for when I'm out doing landscaping and that kind of stuff. So 3 wheel barrels, and then my spreader I use. This shelf right here is my chainsaws, my 16 and then my 18-inch chainsaw, both Husqvarnas. That shelf over there is going to be my bags pack sprayers. I want to need those and kind of landscaping, tarp, pre-emergent, that kind of stuff. So that's just kind of an overview of the shop, man. I am at capacity. I don't have any more room, but I love it. I wouldn't trade it for the world. Again, I recommend you guys utilizing your space and kind of building up if you can. Just do what you can do to kind of figure out. If we come back over to this wall, I actually built this wall. There was no wall here. It was just a staircase. This wall right here, I built and hung up the tracking. Just to kind of hold my tools, man, to get everything off the ground and get everything looking a little more professional. That shelf over there, same with that, just kind of stuff hanging in the corner. I actually built that shelf just to kind of keep everything organized. My mom for my birthday brought me a new table saw. I haven't been able to use it yet. Really hadn't had a, need for it, but it's a good tool to have. So I got it there whenever I'm ready to work with it. I try to keep my shop as organized and efficient as I can, I guess, next I'll let you guys check out the trailer. Let me crack the garage door. We'll see if this security light kicks on or not. There we go. Trailer. You can just kind of stay right there. The trailer is a 14-foot tandem axle. Has a blower rack. The three-tier weed eater rack. Always keep the trash cans with me. Then my cage, I actually had to install just to kind of hold hand tools. If you guys know me, I had some equipment stolen at the start of the season. So this was a big purchase for me as a theft deterrent. To get this, to be able to lock it, to put tools in it, keep an eye on them and make sure they're safe. That's a big thing when I'm on a property now is making sure my stuff doesn't get taken from me. It's one of those things, man. You guys gotta lock your stuff up. And everybody I'm friends with on YouTube that cuts grass, I know a lot of you guys have had stuff taken from you, and it sucks, man. It's one of the worst feelings in the world. But it's one of them things, you just bounce back, keep it moving, and make the best out of it, and just rock it out and go on with it and go forward. If far as the season goes, everything has gone well. I got into a lot more leaf cleanups this year. Was really excited about those. And so I had a lot of fun doing those. In the next couple minutes, I'll let you see a scene of my new blower in action and just kind of a landscaping job I did. Hope you guys are doing well. Keep making money. Stay up. We'll talk to you soon. What's up, guys? James Shields here, Second Mile Service. Out on location, about to rock out a leaf cleanup. Just got started. Not too bad, but definitely could use a cleanup. Got a new Husqvarna 570 BTS backpack blower. The biggest on the market. It's a beast, man. So I'm really excited about using it. Here's a little footage of it in action.
Touch it unless that somebody's me. I gotta be a man.